Hi everybody, hope you are all fine. This is Atiq. I welcome all of you to our YouTube channel Engineering Drive. Today I am going to start the concept of classes and objects in Python. Dear students, we know that in successful object-oriented programming languages, the role of class and object is very important. So as we already know that the programming languages like Java, the reason they became popular is the features of object-oriented programming, and Python also is no way far from them. In Python, all Python programming language also support the concept of object-oriented features. Now, in my today's video, I am going to discuss how we can create a class and how we can create an object for that class in Python program. Dear students, what is the meaning of class? I am not going to give a detailed description about class and object because I don't want to go much more in theory, rather than I am going to show you everything in practicals. Dear students, a class is nothing but a blueprint for an object. What you need to do in a program, you will be writing in a class. And only if you will be writing in a class, there will be no use. You need to implement that. In order to implement that contents of a class, we need to create an object. What is an object? Object is an instance of a class. Okay, by using object, we can access the contents of a class. Dear students, the syntax of using class in Python is of course similar to Java, but there are some major differences that we need to do, that we need to look after here. Okay, so dear students, you can see here in Python, a class can be defined by using a keyword class, same, followed with name of the class. And it is recommended that you can you better start the class name with a capital letter. So here I want to write a Python program to display a value of a variable. Simple program. I am taking a very simple program here to display a value of a variable. So that's why I have taken the name of the class as value. And after the class name, it is mandatory to keep a colon. Whereas this concept is not there in Java to keep the colon, but here in Python program, Python language, in Python programming, you need to make use of the colon operator. Keyword class followed with the class name and the colon operator. Next line. Now, as we know that Python is very strict in the concept of indentation, which means it is mandatory to give the spaces here. So, once I have written the class, I have put one tab here, four spaces. Then, this is a description of the class. And it is optional, but it is recommended to write a description for every Python class. So how to write a description? After the class name, next line, one tab space, that is four spaces, then four double quotations. What I have written? Four double quotations, and I have written description, which means this is a value class. Again, four double quotations close. We call this line as description. Description of a class. So make an habit to write description for every classes whichever you will make use of in your Python programs. So dear student, once you have written the description, then in the same order, in the same alignment, we need to make use of variable now. So this is an instance variable, variable A, and the value is 10. Next, I want to make use of methods. So in every class, there are two important attributes. What are those two important parts? One is variables, another one is methods. Okay. So variable, I have taken one variable, the value is 10. Next, I want to declare one method now. I want to define one method now. So which method is used to define method in our Python? We know that def keyword. Okay, def, def keyword followed with the method name, and in parentheses, there should be compulsory one parameter in our methods. This is mandatory. So here I have taken one parameter self. You can take any name, but I have taken one parameter self, colon. Now, the contents of the method, I can't write immediately in the same alignment because I need to use the concept of indentation. So for that purpose, four spaces again, one tab space I have took. Next, value is equal to dot format of self dot a. I want to access this value of a. Directly I can't access because this value of a, this is a does not belongs to this method, rather this a variable belongs to this value class. Because of that, I need to make use of this parameter to access this a. That's why I have written self dot a. Is it right? Let us say if you use two variables, at that time if you are displaying values of two variables, next line self dot b you need to write. Okay, now class defined, variable assigned, next method also defined. Next, I need to create an object for the class now, because without creating an object, a class is just a framework. So in Java, we can create an object with the help of new keyword, whereas in our Python, how we need to create the object. Now indentation completed from here. Again, come back to the alignment of the class here. Same line you need to write here. V is equal to, I have taken an object name small v, is equal to class name, capital V, value. So which means V is an object which belongs to which class? Value class. So what is the object name? V. Now I want to call this method. Which method? Display method. So by using the object V dot display. V dot display, simply. No need any parameters, because this is an optional parameter and it should be available. It is mandatory that you need to write this parameter, but while calling the method, no need to give the value here. Okay, so V dot display. Whenever I write V dot display, directly control will go to the display method. And what is the expected output in the display method? We have written here, we have written one statement. So the expected output of this program will be, so what is the expected output? Value is equal to, we will get the answer 10 as the output. So whatever the value we have given in A, that value will be displayed as the output. So my dear students, this is how we can create a class in our Python. This is how we can define and declare instance variables. This is how we can declare and define the methods. Okay. What is the main difference between a method and function? If you write the method outside the class, it is a function. If you write it inside a class, it is a method. So a method is nothing but a function which is associated with a class. So I believe that you people have got a clear picture about how to create a class and how to create an object for that class in our Python. So my today's question is, which keyword is used to define a method in Python? So simply put that answer in the comment section. If your answer is correct, you will be getting one like as well as heart from my side. So the question is, remember carefully and listen it, which keyword is used to define method in Python? So with this, let me close my today's session of video. See you soon everybody. Take care. Allah Hafiz.